So when I was young, when I was like probably like 13, 14, you guys know Brian, right?
Yeah.
Wish he was here right now. Brian and I, we had this friend, and his name was Diomi. I fucking love Diomi. He was very similar to me. He was so sensitive. He'd be crying his eyes out right now, too. Diomi. Yeah, man, we were such good friends, you know? And we spent every day together for years. And then, you know, I started to make music and I got signed and I started traveling. And our friendship kind of started to dissipate, you know, fade. We went two different ways. And I remember, you know, Brian would go home sometimes and he would be like, yo, you know, it's, Diomi's like, he's gotten into drugs in a pretty heavy way. Like, it's pretty serious. And I just remember, you know, I mean, at 17, 16, you're just like, I don't even know what to say about that stuff. And I was just so overwhelmed by my life. So much was going on. And I remember I was like, yeah, well, I was probably 19 or 20, 19. And Brian called me one day and he goes, yo, Diomi, he overdosed and he died last night. And I remember Brian was crying on the phone and I was just completely numb. I felt nothing. And, you know, he said to me, his funeral is going to be in a week and a half or something. And I was on tour and I couldn't make it. And so I sent some money or something, I don't know. And yeah, I never was there. And to be honest, I didn't think about him. I didn't think about him for years. So we're in the studio making music. This was a few months ago. I'm sitting there. And they have this title, Heart of Gold. And we're like, what's this about? What is this about? You know, is this about me? What is this? And Scott, like he does, he always finds the truth. Scott said, didn't you have a friend who passed away from an overdose? And I mean, I literally must have just blocked it from my mind because my answer was no. Brian was sitting in front of me. He said his name. He said, Diomi. And the second he said his name, it just all caught up to me. Years of pain that I never processed. Obviously still happened. All caught up to me. And oh man, this song was hard to write. It took a few days and I don't know what to say. It felt like a letter to him, wherever he is, all the things I never got to say to him, all the things I wanted to say to him. And you know, when someone dies of an overdose, I imagine, you know, it was an accident, and I imagine, like, wherever you go, you kind of just wake up, and you're like, what happened? You know, I was just there, and now I've left everyone behind, and I can imagine, you know, feeling like guilt or shame or anything, and I just had this image of, like, wherever he was, like, in the studio that day, like, this song just being this beautiful golden ray of light coming up out of the roof and blasting through the roof to find him wherever he was and just cover him in that light. And then it just was like, you know, every time I knew, every time that we got to play this song, every time people started to learn the song, they'd be singing, he would hear it, and it just felt like the greatest thing ever. And so, yeah, man, this is one of my favorites on the album, so I love it. Tell me I love you, man. This one is for you. I hope you guys enjoy. This is called Heart of Gold. We'll be right back.
heart of gold. Your heart of gold.